Good morning, viewers. Today we have Mr. Tarun Kocher, Director, Vijon Group. Welcome, Mr. Kocher, to our show.
Thank you so much.
I hear you are the largest shaving cream selling brand in the world.
Yeah.
Is that true?
It's true. Totally true.
We are largest, world's largest shaving cream brand. That's huge to, very proud to know that an Indian brand is having that space. So please share the beginning of Vijon, how it started and what has been the journey so far.
See, Vijon is, I think it's not a brand which is not known. Everybody knows the brand since about, it started 1960 by my great-grandfather, Suchi Singh Kocher. And we started from the pavement of the Chandni Chowk, Old Delhi. And 60 years now, still running, still going, going good, going great. He had a vision, which I think vision continues, what we say. It's his vision continues and I think he sees the brand and the company somewhere down the line, and 6 years we are the third generation and still going strongfold in the market and expansioning in day by day, and you know, multiple businesses we are in, multiple folds, not only in FMCG, we into confectionery and beverages and real estate, we hospitality, hotels and restaurants, and so these are multiple vertical legs what we have. So that makes the group goes to this growth level today as
awesome.
Well.
Yeah. Awesome.
Yeah. See, as a group, we've started from zero to now we have 450, you can write 450 crores right now at the group. Okay. And employees, overall about 3,000 employees at the
3,000
group.
3,000 employees?
Yeah, in the group. So,
in 60 years?
60 years
from zero to 450 crores and almost 3,000 employees. That's fantastic, awesome growth. So Tarun, tell me, when did you start your journey at Vijon?
Me personally, if you say, it's been it's in the blood, first of all. The blood, when I was born, it started then only. And if you say, to be precise, after my college and after I finished my graduation, I was here and I had multiple things in mind. We entered into breweries. Mm-hmm. So that project was in my hand. So we've had breweries earlier. So we got Mahu, San Miguel from Spain. We got them in India, did a giant joint venture. That was my project altogether. And then after that, and it's everything is there in front of you. It's going on good. And about 20 years now, 20 years in the business now. And,
okay.
Yeah, 20 years now. And,
good. So how and when did you venture into exports? I understand you take care of exports here.
Yeah. I handle the total international part, department, division and division, import and export of Vijon Group. After the brewery joint venture, then I looked into upon when I entered the business, this was a part, I thought there was a gap in our international, the kind of strong presence we had in India. So I thought there's something lacking in internationally, people don't know the brand, let's do something which is the gap is and make people also recognize the brand internationally, mm-hmm. not only in India where we are the leaders, you know. So I think that was something I choose my own vision, my vision of taking the brand internationally, globally and, you know, and taking to next level. So that was my vision of when I joined Vijon.
Export in how many countries, Tarun?
Exporting to about 55 countries.
What's the turnover of exports?
The turnover of exports, you can say about 10 to 15% of the turnover, total turnover.
So tell me, what are the three things you do differently to balance profitability and low prices?
That's a very good question, actually. So because that's a hurdle you get in internationally when you are knowing about the markets, you get a profitability. Some products are obviously locally produced. If I say when the products are locally produced, you get a tough competition with the local players which are already selling much more lower pricing because they are locally manufacturing that, and then you how to maintain the profitability. Mm-hmm. So that's the great main thing actually. Yes. How it comes. So
profitability, I would even add quality with this.
Quality with that. So basically the three things I'll say about what my thing is that targeting the upmarket products, what customer is spending on that, adding into your portfolio.
Okay.
Upmarket products along what you have. So and second is innovating. If you innovate those products, what the upmarket products are selling, what customer needs. Mm-hmm. So you balance your profitability of selling what you have. Maybe you have tough competition in certain product. So you balance with the adding the high upmarket, you know, that portfolio, and balance your profitability and earn both ways. And take a more market share, I think. Cater to different TG also. You know, and third, keeping the price low than the the high value competitors. Okay. Keeping a bit low price with the high value competitors, and then I think this give a better chance to balance the profitability for overall as a portfolio.
Okay.
Yeah.
Awesome strategies. Thank you, Tarun. So could you share an interesting event where market research brought a turning point in your business?
See, I'll not say a turning point, but I'll say a gain of knowledge. If I'll say, then you, when you're having a market research and you're traveling and then you get into all this and studying the trends and everything, some insights come and you actually follow that insight, something new for you to learn actually. So like, I give you a small example, just, and like a hair removal cream. Hair removal cream, the woman, female hair removal cream.
Okay.
We are the leading in jar pack in India in volumes.
Okay.
And so we used to always think that this product is always for the females. Mm-hmm. So I think we were wrong on that part, or maybe certain market research showed us that internationally when we traveled, did a market research and everything, I think it was used highly by men separately also.
Okay.
and we used to think that the men use the female product. We used to think that, yeah, that was a misconception. I think that was, then we launched our brand about 2 years back, Masterstroke. We joined Masterstroke hair removal cream for men, especially for men.
Okay.
So we came into that insight after all the market research analysis. So, you know what I mean? So that's a very core turning point into our business. We entered into that category. We were the first one to do it in India.
Okay.
And the competition followed us.
Okay.
Yeah. So that's something which is a turning point for the company now. Yeah.
So market research opened up a completely new category.
Yeah.
While the product existed.
Yeah.
You just had to package it and launch it.
No, for men, obviously, it's totally different skin type and everything. Obviously, that's different. Obviously, men have a different skin than females. Okay. We always had a thought that men use the same female product.
Okay.
But if you see, get a market analysis, men is totally different. When internationally, if you travel, men uses a totally different category of hair removal cream for the specialized for men. That category was totally open for us to enter, and I think that really helped us market research analysis to, you know, get into all this and enter into new portfolio.
Fantastic. So thank you so much, Tarun, for your wonderful insights.
You're
and
welcome.
I'm sure our readers would be really helped by this amazing success story.